On Water Wednesdays this week, while I'm spending some time in London, many of us here in the diaspora are very concerned and watching developments there in Barbados, as many of you have been without water for the past 24 to 48 hours. The Barbados Water Authority, for its part, has been working around the clock trying to find solutions to the problem there. To tell us a bit more about the response and what has been happening is the Director of Engineering, Charles Leslie.
We use groundwater, and to get the groundwater to the surface and then get it to the customer's premises, we have to use pumps and motors, and these pumps and motors use electrical power. And for the instance, in circumstances of the wastewater section, we use pumps, blowers, clarifiers, different processes to treat the waste, and all of them require power as well. If there's no electricity from the Barbados Light and Power, the Barbados Water Authority in some instances utilizes standby generation to provide that electricity. We don't have standby generators for all of our plants. We have for the major plants. In the wastewater section, we have approximately 9 or 10 generators in the wastewater section. Those are fixed generators at lift stations and at the treatment plants. And in the potable water section, we have as many as 12 or 13 generators, some portable and some fixed. But we don't have generators for all of our facilities. We're working towards being able to have some sort of standby power for a lot of the other facilities, but at this point in time, we don't have that. Even when power goes and then it is restored, the Barbados Water Authority, we utilize three phases. We use three phase power. For residences, most residences just use one phase. So when power is restored, we still have to ensure that it is stable, because any one of those phases off by too much will cause damage to our infrastructure. So sometimes you hear customers saying, okay, but the power is back on in my area, why can't we start to pump again? But we have to do our checks and balances to make sure that the station, everything at the station is satisfied before we can start back up again. In cases of emergency, we normally have procedures where we go through. We work very closely with the Barbados Light and Power, because we have a protocol and we have a priority list where we try to re-establish power to the major facilities first, and then the peripheral facilities go afterwards. The Barbados Water Authority has a limited fleet of tankers. We have 13 tankers. And what we normally do is those tankers are called upon in the case where you don't have pipe-borne water going up to the residents. Our staff normally works very long hours with those tankers, but sometimes because of the circumstances, you want those tankers to be out for longer hours, and we would normally call on the defense forces in terms of emergency to assist us in those circumstances. The Barbados Water Authority would like to thank the customers for bearing with us over the last couple of days. We also are trying to encourage our customers to store water. We are still in the hurricane season. We always encourage you to store additional water in your houses, and we would also like to commend our staff, Corporate Barbados, for assisting us as well, because we enlisted the services of some private personnel, electricians to help us with generators, contractors to help us to prepare for the generators, as well as the private tankers that you have been seeing in the field. So we'd like to thank our staff, Corporate Barbados, and our customers for bearing with us over the last couple of days and assisting us. Thank you very much.
Of course, you'll be getting more updates right here on Water Wednesdays. To view this or a previous episode again, please go to our website, www.barbadoswaterauthority.com. You can go to our Facebook page for additional information, or just type Water Wednesdays in YouTube. You can find us there.